It's December. It's getting closer to Christmas. We have college hoops. Pretty soon we'll be welcoming the NBA back into our life. And I feel like it's only right if we talk opening night and some NBA futures. First, we'll start with an NBA future, and that is the Boston Celtics plus 250 to win the Atlantic Division Eastern Conference. I feel like out of all the teams in the Atlantic, this team has the most stability within their coaching staff and their roster. The favorite to win the Atlantic is the Nets, and in my opinion, they're way overhyped. I can definitely see this team being good, but it's going to take them a little while to figure things out and to gel. I mean, even when you look at the big three in Miami, it took them a while to figure things out, and I kind of see that going the same way this year with the Nets, only with more Kyrie drama.
So what about 7 post-ups instead of 8?
I mean, we negotiated that thing. I thought we was going to do 2.5.
My next future is the Golden State Warriors plus 2,600 to win the entire NBA championship. Let me start by saying that I do think the Lakers do win it all again this year. I mean, they actually improved their roster last year and I feel like are set to just run it back. But that's why you're seeing them for as low as plus 260 to win the whole thing. And that is just way too expensive to put on a ticket where anything could happen. I mean, LeBron goes down, Anthony Davis goes down, then you're stuck with a ticket with absolutely no value. And that's why I'm going with the Warriors. Losing Klay Thompson for the year was absolutely terrible for the Warriors and for fans of the NBA. I mean, watching that dude shoot is a treat and he is so underrated. However, I felt like it was a bit of a market overreaction whenever they took him from plus 900 to plus 2600 on account of Klay. You still have Steph Curry, you still have Draymond, Wiggins should be much improved over the last year. Oubre should be an awesome addition. And as I said, consistency and continuity is going to be so huge this year, and that Warriors coaching staff has it in Kerr. And again, just to make it clear, do I think the Warriors have the best shot to win it all? No, I don't. But I think there's a ton of value there at plus 2600. Opening night preview. I am taking the Warriors plus 5. I stated earlier that consistency is going to be key this year, and I just do not see the Nets coming out very fluid. I mean, you have a new coaching staff, you have 2 superstars, so you don't know how they're going to mesh, and 5 points seems like a lot to lay with someone where you don't really know what you're getting yet. Where on the other side, you have the Warriors, and I think that KD being on the opposite bench is going to give them some motivation to be like, hey, NBA, y'all remember me? Next, I'm taking the Lakers -2.5, and I'm just not overthinking it. The Lakers improved their championship roster, whereas the Clippers really didn't. And sure, they have Kawhi, and it always feels like you're in it if you have Kawhi, but I just don't think they're gonna be able to stand up to this Lakers team. Per rumors, whether LeBron's playing or not playing, and I think that's reflected in this line. Either way, I think we see a humongous game from a healthy AD, and I'm taking the Lakers -2.5. All right, y'all, that's all I have for this week. Bring on the NBA, and let's make some money.